to flying with many other Canadians during his time in the Royal Air Force. One man that merits our attention was Don Frazee. Pilot Donald Weston Frazee enlisted March the 12th, 1941, in his hometown of Vancouver, British Columbia. He worked downtown at the Royal Bank of Canada on Robson Street. Donald and Frederick's paths would have crossed sometime in the early months of 1942. They were enrolled in the same advanced unit at Breeze Norton. In fact, we could see by Frederick's logbook that they piloted several training flights together. About a year later, both men ended up in Malta flying Beaufighters for 272 Squadron. They flew many of the same missions well into the spring of 1943. Here is a series of pictures taken when both men were present, celebrating their safe landings after a hard day's flight. On March 17, 1943, pilot Frazee and his observer Sergeant Sandery took off from Takali Airfield, Malta. 18 minutes into their flight, the plane began to vibrate and lose speed rapidly. There was no option but to ditch the aircraft into the sea. Sergeant Frazee reported at the time,
"I remember a flood of water coming in through the top hatch. Upon releasing my safety harness, I kept my parachute on and experienced no difficulty in climbing out. As I turned, I saw my observer had freed himself as well. By the time we had both floated free, the aircraft had disappeared into the depths."
Decades later, Donald Weston Frazee's Beaufighter was located half a mile off Dragonera Point. It is now a popular destination for scuba divers who chance the waters off the beautiful island of Malta. So sorry.
There'll be no one unless that someone is you. borrow. Have it to...
April 7th, 1943. Flight Sergeant Frederick Albert Duquette, Air Crew Sergeant's Mess, RAF, TAC Ali, Malta. Dear Bert and Pat, just a few words to let you know that I am still around. Things are okay around here. I was given quite a surprise last night, though. We were in the intelligence room when the CO came up to me and said, "Congratulations, you are a flight sergeant." That's given up all hope of ever receiving my crown. The fellows that stayed in Canada are flight lieutenants and warrant officers. Still, they can have their Ansons and Cessnas. I am flying a real aeroplane. How is the Air Force treating you? I am very much behind on news. The last letter I received from you was dated last October. I received that a few days ago. You should be at service now. Do you like flying? Oh well, the first 400 hours are the most exciting. After that, the novelty sort of wears off. Well, I guess I'd better end this thing. I have work to do. You can draw your own conclusions as to what it is. So long for now. Hoping to hear from you real soon. Your brother, Fred.